I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 91.1. Questioner, could you first please give me the condition of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. It is as previously stated. Question 91.2. Questioner, I have listed the different minds and would like to know if they are applied in this particular aspect. First, we have the cosmic mind, which is, I would think, the same for all sublogua like our sun. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 91.3. Questioner, a sublogos such as our sun, then, in creating its own particular evolutionary experience, refines the cosmic mind or, shall we say, articulates it by its own additional bias or biases. Is this the correct observation? Answer, I am Ra. It is a correct observation with the one exception that concerns the use of the term, addition, which suggests the concept of that which is more than the all mind. Instead, the archetypical mind is a refinement of the all mind in a pattern peculiar to the sublogos choosing. Question 91.4. Questioner, then the very next refinement that occurs as the cosmic mind is refined is what we call the archetypical mind. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. Yes. Question 91.5. Questioner, then this creates, I would assume, the planetary or racial mind. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. No. Question 91.6. Questioner, what is the origin of the planetary or racial mind? Answer, I am Ra. This racial or planetary mind is, for this logos, a repository of biases remembered by the mind, body, spirit complexes which have enjoyed the experience of this planetary influence. Question 91.7. Questioner, now, some entities on this planet evolved from second density into third and some were transferred from other planets to recycle in third density here. Did the ones who were transferred here to recycle in third density and to the planetary or racial mind? Answer, I am Ra. Not only did each race enter the planetary mind, but also each race possesses a racial mind. Thus we made this distinction in discussing this portion of mind. This portion of mind is formed in the series of seemingly non-simultaneous experiences which are chosen in freedom of will by the mind, body, spirit complexes of the planetary influence. Therefore, although this akashic, planetary, or racial mind is indeed a root of mind, it may be seen in sharp differentiation from the deeper roots of mind which are not a function of altering memory, if you will. We must ask your patience at this time. This channel has become somewhat unclear due to the movement of the cover which touches this instrument. We ask that the opening sentences be repeated and the breath expelled. The microphones attached to the cover upon the instrument were pulled slightly as a rug was being placed over a noisy tape recorder. The circle of one was walked, breath was expelled 2 feet above the instrument's head from her right to her left, and the circle of one was walked again as requested. Question 91.8, I am Ra. We communicate now. Question 91.9. Questioner, were we successful in re-establishing clear contact? Answer, I am Ra. There was the misstep which then needed to be re-repeated. This was done. The communication is once again clear. We enjoyed the humorous aspects of the necessary repetitions. Question 91.10. Questioner, what occurred when the microphone corns were slightly moved? Answer, I am Ra. The link between the instrument's mind, body, spirit complex and its yellow ray, chemical, physical vehicle was jarred. This caused some maladjustment of the organ you call the lungs and, if the repair had not been done, would have resulted in a distorted physical complex condition of this portion of the instrument's physical vehicle. Question 91.11. Questioner, what kind of distortion? Answer, I am Ra. The degree of distortion would depend upon the amount of neglect. The ultimate penalty, shall we say, for the disturbing of the physical vehicle is the death, in this case by what you would call the congestive heart failure. As the support group was prompt, there should be little or no distortion experienced by the instrument. Question 91.12. Questioner, Why does such a very minor effect like the slight movement of the microphone cord result in this situation, not mechanically or chemically, but philosophically, if you can answer this question? Answer, I am Ra. We can only answer mechanically as there is no philosophy to the reflexes of physical vehicular function. There is what you might call the silver cord reflex, that is, when the mind, body, spirit complex dwells without the environs of the physical shell and the physical shell is disturbed, the physical shell will reflexively call back the absent enlivener, that is, the mind, body, spirit complex which is connected with what may be metaphysically seen as what some of your philosophers have called the silver cord. If this is done suddenly, the mind, body, spirit complex will attempt entry into the energy web of the physical vehicle without due care, and the effect is as if one were to stretch one of your elastic bands and let it shrink rapidly. The resulting snap would strike hard at the anchored portion of the elastic band. The process through which you as a group go in recalling this instrument could be likened unto taking this elastic and gently lessening its degree of tension until it was without perceptible stretch. Question 91.13. Questioner, to get back to what we were talking about, would the different races of this planet be from different planets in our local vicinity or the planets of nearby Logwa which have evolved through their second density experiences, and would they create the large number of different races that we experience on this planet? Answer, I am Ra. There are correctnesses to your supposition. However, not all races and sub-races are of various planetary origins. We suggest that in looking at planetary origins one observes not the pigmentation of the integument but the biases concerning interactions with other selves and definitions regarding the nature of the self. Question 91.14. Questioner, how many different planets have supplied the individuals which now inhabit this planet? Answer, I am Ra. This is perceived by us to be unimportant information, but harmless. There are three major planetary influences upon your planetary sphere besides those of your own second density derivation, and 13 minor planetary groups in addition to the above. Question 91.15. Questioner, thank you. One more question before we start on the specific questions in regard to archetypes. Do all Logwa evolving after the veil have 22 archetypes? Answer, I am Ra. No. Question 91.16. Questioner, is it common for Logwa to have 22 archetypes or is this relatively unique to our Logos? Answer, I am Ra. The system of sevens is the most articulated system yet discovered by any experiment by any Logos in our octave. Question 91.17. Questioner, what is the largest number of archetypes, to Ra's knowledge, used by our Logos? Answer, I am Ra. The sevens plus the choice is the greatest number which has been used, by our knowledge, by Logwa. It is the result of many, many previous experiments in articulation of the One Creator. Question 91.18. Questioner, I assume, then, the 22 is the greatest number of archetypes. I also ask, is it the minimum number presently in use by any Logos to Ra's knowledge? Answer, I am Ra. The fewest are the two systems of five which are completing the cycles or densities of experience. You must grasp the idea that the archetypes were not developed at once but step by step and not in order as you know the order of this space-time but in various orders. Therefore, the two systems of fives were using two separate ways of viewing the archetypical nature of all experience. Each, of course, use the matrix, the potentiator, and the significator, for this is the harvest with which our creation began. One way or system of experimentation had added to these the catalyst and the experience. Another system, if you will, had added catalyst and transformation. In one case the methods whereby experience was processed was further aided but the fruits of experience less aided. In the second case the opposite may be seen to be the case. Question 91.19. Questioner, thank you. We have some observations on the archetypes which are as follows. First, the matrix of the mind is depicted in the Egyptian tarot by a male, and this we take as creative energy intelligently directed. Will Ra comment on this? Answer, I am Ra. This is an extremely thoughtful perception, seeing as it does the male not specifically as biological male but as a male principle. You will note that there are very definite sexual biases in the images. They are intended to function both as information as to which biological entity or energy will attract which archetype, and also as a more general view which sees polarity as a key to the archetypical mind of third density.